I'm Shikshya Gautam, and I'm a volunteer from e-Nable Nepal, which is a Nepal chapter of the Geneva movement. It's a non-governmental social organization with the government of Nepal and Social Welfare Council of Nepal. The organization is made up of educators, journalists, medical professionals, philanthropists, government ex-servicemen, and government workers who want to give something back to the people and society of Nepal, who was established in May 2018. e-Nable Nepal is committed to serve the children with disability, especially those who have lost hands by various reasons or by birth, by providing 3D-printed prosthetic hands, which we believe will help the children to ease their daily life, along with the access to the health education and skill development trainings. I would also like to give short introduction of our board of directors who initiated the e-Nable movement in Nepal. I'm Chakura, like the chairman of our organization. Hemantara has spoken the vice chairman, Srinath Shrestha, general secretary, Dinesh Rajbandari, secretary, Tony Shrestha, treasurer, Vinod Dangi, Samad Shrestha, and Siddharth Siraj Shrestha is a member of our organization. Initially, e-Nable Nepal was supported by e-Nable Alliance and e-Nable Canada for setting up the lab. Peter Byron and Lucy Shrestha from e-Nable Canada conducted training on 3D printing Phoenix version 2 hand and the unlimited arm for Nepali volunteers. The little girl in the picture is our first recipient, Khushi Shrestha, sitting with her father, with Peter Byron, Rishi Shrestha, and volunteers of e-Nable Nepal. Our mission is to provide services and supports to foster independence and improve the quality of life for differently abled children. Our goal is to produce and provide 3D-printed prosthetics hand to children with upper limb deficiency for free of cost with the help of national and international organizations. Regarding our progress, we have distributed 55 hands till now. We are also conducting research on the topics, outcome of 3D-printed functional prosthesis for children with upper limb deficiency in Nepal. We are also doing research on fabrication and development of low-cost wearable binding arm using EMG sensors. Today, I will talk briefly about how we made hands in e-Nable Nepal. Till now, in e-Nable Nepal, we are distributing two types of devices, Phoenix version 2 and Unlimited Arm version 2.1. Phoenix version 2 is wrist-powered device, which usually requires a functional wrist and enough palm to push against the device. For those who do not have enough wrist, this version needs an elevated arm device, that is Unlimited Arm version 2.1. Due to the time constraint, I will just present brief explanation of how we made the hand. This is the overall process of making the hand, which includes finding recipients, taking measurements, customizing sizing, open SCAD, generating STL files, generating G-code files, 3D printing, assembling, and finally distributing the hands. To find the recipient, initially e-Nable Nepal spread the news about availability of 3D printed prosthetic hands in Nepal through social media like Facebook and Twitter. And around 35 recipients and their parents immediately responded to the news and they sent their petition to receive the 3D printed hands to e-Nable Nepal. In the next step, we extended the news through personal contact, social communities, schools, and the national television channels. Now more recipients are in contact and filing their records in our database. For the process, we can simply start by going to the Enabling the Future website and get involved by choosing a hand option. There is a step-by-step instruction. We can choose e-Nable device catalog, which will open up e-Nable Hub platform. Then we can select the hand design and arm design of Phoenix version 2 and Phoenix Unlimited arm design by the team Unlimited. After choosing the hand, we will get the files and resources, clicking on the STL file links, which will open up Thingiverse website where we can download the CAD file and customize the STL files. Here are the some pictures of volunteers taking measurement of hands. One more pictures. This is the sample of measurement form we are using in e-Nable Nepal. We collect some basic data. We all need to measure the bicep of measurement of bicep circumference of affected hand. We also need a forearm, wrist, and hand length of normal hand to input data in CAD software. However, we fill all the parameters in the form to ensure the easy fit if necessary later. We use the OpenSCAD for the customization, which you can find in the Thingiverse website. You can download from the Thingiverse. In OpenSCAD, we customize the size of the hand of specific recipient. We input the data in this customizer parameter. We generate the and save the STL files of each part of the hand. Like we generate the STL files individually, different parts like cuff, cheek, palm, finger, phalanx, piece, etc. These are the different parts of the hands, which are printed for which we create the STL file individually. The STL files of palm, finger, and these parts is then converted to G-code file by using a slicing software called Cura. We can also use other slicing softwares like Slicer. We then set the required setting like the filament, required temperature, infill, bed adhesion, support if required. We generally use PLA and PG filaments here to make a hand. We then transfer the generated G-code file to the SD card, which is ready to print on the printer. After transferring the generated G-code file to the SD card, the next step would be printing. We have 5 3D printers in Nepal, 2 Prusa MK3, 2 Creality Ender, and 1 Creality 10S. Printing is quite easy. However, what challenges us is troubleshooting the printers at times. Thanks to the worldwide volunteer from e-Nable who are quite accessible through Facebook groups and e-Nable Hub, where we got help when required. Then the different parts of the hand will be ready for the assembling. We can also find step-by-step guidelines on assembling the hand in e-Nable in the future website. These printed parts of the hand is then assembled to make a functional hand. The process of assembling the hand includes thermoforming the arm and cuff. The most challenging step in assembling first is thermoforming the arm and cuff, as it depends upon the type of filament we use, and sometimes it creates problems and we have to reprint the parts and repeat the process. Other steps include spinning up, stringing the hand, attaching padding in the cuff and arm, adding elastic band to join finger, phalanx, and palm, adding Velcro, and finally finishing the arm or hand. Distributing the hand is the most satisfying step of making a hand. Total hand making process takes around approximately 3 to 4 days if the printing goes well. These are the pictures of our recipient after receiving the hand. Here are some more pictures of our recipient. The smile in their face is our reward, actually. These hands are not only making these kids independent, but also giving hope and inspiration to do better in their life. They are much more confident after receiving the hand. I'm really thankful for this amazing movement of e-Nable in the future. It's great to be a part of this amazing community. Thank you so much.
Thank you. So I don't know if anyone has some questions.
Every time I hear a chapter tell its story, I'm astounded and gratified. e-Nable Nepal popped up unexpectedly in my world, out of nowhere. I've corresponded with Shikshya for years, but I've never seen her face to face. And the work of her chapter and her use of all of the materials that other chapters have produced is really a good example of how this network grows and interacts, even though, frankly, we're fairly ignorant about each other's activities.
I saw Pierre had a question to John in regard to how you spread like the updates, in fact. Can you say a word about that?
These days, and this has been difficult, there is one right place to go for the latest designs, and that is the e-Nable Hub at hub.e-nable.org. In the picture I showed you of the kinetic hand, you see that the devices are listed. You can see when it was updated. We have ratings of maturity, cost of materials, popularity, difficulty, and grip strength. And when changes occur, they are announced there. Meanwhile, however, the truth is there are variations and copies all over the place, including Thingiverse and GitHub and YouMagine and all of these other websites. And those are often specialized customizations or souvenirs. And it's actually a challenge to weed out obsolete models.